These are my friends. Some of them I've known for a long time, and some of them I've met doing what we all love doing, rollerblading. Or as I like to just call it, blading. We all live here in New York City. Cody and I have known each other the longest. We go back 10 years ago as pups in the city we used to call home, San Francisco. I rollerbladed a bit there, but we started rollerblading together actually here in New York City. The first year in New York, Cody kept telling me to get a pair of new wheels. The second year, I did, and nothing has been more liberating. Last year, I just started to film all of our blading adventures, and on day one, we happened to meet Jerry, who has been on wheels for 30 years and counting. He is the rollerblader that I want to be when I'm 30 plus years on the path. Great form, he skates as often as possible. Nothing stops him, and that's why we always run into him on the path. Then there's my friend Andrew. He lives uptown near me, and I was his Cody, pushing him to use his rollerblades. And then one day we rollerbladed to 125th from George Washington Bridge, then the second time to Midtown. I think I had him hooked because the third time he went for the gold and rollerbladed to South Ferry and back, which is 20 miles. The youngest of the group is Vladimir. We also met him on the path one afternoon. Myself and Andrew were underneath George Washington Bridge, and we saw that he had a pair of wheels, and I just asked him simply, "Do you want to blade with us?" Honestly, I didn't think that he would blade with two strangers all evening long, but he did. And that's the thing about rollerblading. It has brought five strangers together, and here's our story. How'd you get started blading?
I tried to speed skate with blades years ago when I was a kid, and it was really hard. And I remember thinking to myself, I'd rather just stick to the ice. Well, then when I moved to New York, I didn't have my bike accessible anymore, and I had a friend that showed me how to rollerblade. Taught me how, essentially, and the rest is history. Night blading's great because there's not a lot of people out. There's enough street lights that you can see your way around the city pretty easily, and the cars can see you if you wear something bright. So night blading is definitely a treat if you're willing to do it. I have a special light for my helmet so people can see me. And I can see other people. Rollerblading in New York is great because it's all flat, and there's a lot of places designated for people to bike and rollerblade, so it makes it easy. And there's actually groups and community that gets together to do it. There's also some places in the park to skate in the summertime, so it's definitely a community activity. And I find the rollerblading community to be really inclusive and open-minded, just into blading for the same reasons, to see the sights and exercise and, of course, meet people.
Hey, I'm Andrew. I'm 26 years old. I started rollerblading when I was about, I want to say 10 years old, but I got started rollerblading in New York through a good friend named Lemiron. He really inspired me to pick up those rollerblades that I had decided to buy about a year ago, and I hadn't really used them a lot, and so that really motivated me to take that next step and find all kinds of amazing trails out there in the city that were unknown to me until I really did some exploration. The rollerblading community here in New York City is a very eclectic group of people. We love to get together whenever we can. I find that the friends that I have made through rollerblading are very open and very adventurous to exploring all of the beautiful sights around New York City, definitely giving me more of an insight in how freeing you can be through rollerblading and how you can mesh with bikes, buses, cars, taxi cabs. It really gave me the opportunity to command the space in the streets and to really flow with the speed of traffic, just like life. Nightblading is something that is such a fun recreational activity. It brings so much enthusiasm and energy throughout your body, and it gives you a whole nother view of the city. I really enjoy rollerblading at night. It's actually a whole nother experience versus rollerblading in the day. It's almost a little bit more peaceful, actually. It feels like I'm invisible, I'm a part of the night, and it brings me this nocturnal energy that I so long to feel. It's truly an amazing experience to be able to view the city and see all of its lights and see the world around you, and it's a great experience, honestly. The lights really illuminate the trails in which we are blading on, and the waters from the Hudson River are really, they really sparkle in the moonlight.
Hi, my name is Jerry Solon.
And how did you get started into rollerblading?
That goes back to Minneapolis, where they were born. And the first time I ever saw rollerblades was my freshman year of high school. It was summer of 81, and I saw these hockey player guys skating in a parking lot, and it's July, with their hockey sticks and pucks, but they had these wheels on their boots. I'd never seen that before. And this is back in 1981 in July. So that goes way back. And I think those were the first random pair of rollerblades ever worn, as far as I'm concerned. And I thought, I gotta try that someday. So eventually I did. I was one day running around one of the lakes in the city. I was really getting tired of running. I used to run a lot. I decided I want to try rollerblading. And they had a rollerblading rental little shop off the lake I was running on. So I literally ran to that little shop, bought a pair of rollerblades, put my running shoes around my shoulder, and put the blades on and just bladed around the lake and never stopped. And that was back in 1984. So it's been a while. I love blading day or night. Nighttime is magical, especially in New York. I particularly blade along the river, so you have the reflection of the lights along the river. There's less people, so it's way more peaceful and therapeutic and just joyous to be skating at night. And thrilling, less really to be concerned about, because it's just nighttime. So I find it very like me time to be skating at night. The rollerblading community in New York, I find to be very dynamic and exciting. It's a consistently happy group of people. People who rollerblade are happy. They're liberated. They're healthy. It's like we all have this kind of known inside secret of how cool it is to rollerblade, and it's some people don't think that unless they are rollerblading. And we can maneuver through traffic. We have power and control of our destiny. We're not stuck in underground in a subway if we're commuting on rollerblades. And there's a lot of rollerbladers in the city. If you go to Union Square on a Wednesday night at 7:30, that's where everybody congregates as the rollerbladers, and they take over the city and blade everywhere. But people who don't rollerblade seems like they never see them around. They don't know they exist. But there's a lot. So I think it's a tight-knit community, and they're out there, and they're out there having fun. And I think if everybody rollerbladed, it would be a much healthier world to live in. Less pollution, healthier people.
I'm Vladimir, and I'm 20 years old. I started skating not too long ago, five months back. And I started skating when I found these skates outside of my door. It was a gift from God. Usually when I roller skate, I'm always out by myself. Always by myself, and I just love it. Just like going out, looking at the scenery, and just relaxing. That's the best part. Just relaxing, listening to music, and just gliding through the air and watching the nice sunset. It's beautiful.
Hi, I'm Lemiron Starling. I'm 30 years old, and how I got started rollerblading was actually from when I was a kid. I started roller skating at a roller rink, so when I was about 16, I asked for a pair of rollerblades. Well, the funny thing is, I really didn't use those rollerblades really until I turned about 21, 22 while I was living in San Francisco. And I'll start from my friend Igor. He was always rollerblading in San Francisco, like downhills, uphills. And so they really inspired me. I bought them, and after I worked out, I would rollerblade down the Embarcadero in San Francisco, and it would be like my little peaceful time to myself after a workout, and I would do it mostly at night or sometimes on a Sunday during the day. And then when I moved from San Francisco and eventually here to New York, my friend Cody told me the same thing. Why don't you get a pair of rollerblades? And I finally bought a pair of rollerblades. And then the rest was history. I start rollerblading all the time, year round. It was like it became not just something I did in leisure, but something I did as just a part of my weekly routine, like me on rollerblades, blading to see Cody, or rollerblading to work, or just rollerblading to go to the movies. Instead of using my car, I've just put on my wheels and just go. And the nice thing is, I live uptown in Washington Heights, and so it makes it easy for me to get up and down the island, because it's about a 10-minute walk from my apartment down by the river where I start out rollerblading. And if I'm rollerblading to work, I can be there within 35 minutes. It's kind of amazing, the fact that you can do that in a city like New York. Out of all the places I've lived, between Texas, San Francisco, Milano, Italy, and here in New York, having rollerblades here, I never would have thought that I could get around so much. It's like, amazes me the fact that I can go all the way from Washington Heights and make it all the way down the South Ferry, like One World Trade. And I didn't drive, I didn't take a train, I didn't use a bike. I can carry this mail, I don't have to worry about locking it up and worrying about someone stealing it. It's like this little bit of liberation and freedom. And every time it amazes me, the fact that I can just do so much on them and I meet so many people, whether they are rollerbladers or not rollerbladers. And it's one of those ways you still can connect with people, you connect with the city, you connect with the nature. You just, it puts you in a nice spot that only that true happiness and euphoria can bring. So night blading all kind of started because actually me and Cody were wanting to go rollerblading and it got dark, and so I just thought, you know what, let's go out at night, why not? It's like less people. I was off work late, and so we got us a late start. By night blading, I mean not just at dusk or rollerblading, it got dark, which has happened to us before, but like actually going out at night. After the first time we did it, I was just kind of like, that was pretty awesome, pretty amazing, just to be out at night on our wheels. There's not that many people running, like pulling their bikes. You don't have that many tourists out in the way. Granted that you have a little bit of visibility problem as far as us seeing parts of the road or potholes or dips in the road or people seeing us, we ended up figuring out ways around it. And so we started wearing our lights and got more advanced lights for our helmets. And then I ended up getting wheels that have lights. I ended up finding that by accident, these LED wheels that seem pretty cool. And then it just kind of took it to a whole new way of rollerblading, is rollerblading at night, and especially those wheels. People see me coming a mile away. I get stopped all the time by cars or people walking by, like, that's cool, or like, oh, that's awesome, I want those, where did you get those? It's a real conversation piece. And then the fact that you just see me coming on these wheels, I feel like I'm in like Tron or something, or Speed Racer. Like, I feel like a superhero almost with like all these lights on. And the other thing with night blading is that you get to see a different side of the city when it's a little bit more calmer. It's almost like when it snows here in New York. There's less people out, and it's, you almost feel like you have the city to yourself, which is rare to feel like that in a city of almost 9 million people, or 9 million people, however many people we have here in New York City. And then there's the night blading part of me rollerblading back home. I like to just rollerblade all day with the guys, and when I'm on my way back up, sometimes it's by myself, sometimes it's not, but either way, it's just me, or if I'm with some of the guys like Andrew or Vladimir, rollerblading back up at night after I get past 96th Street, it's almost myself. I may run into one or two other bikers, and that's it. It almost feels like I'm going through the woods and like a long journey home. I feel like a little bit magical almost. And all I see is George Washington Bridge in the distance, and it just slowly gets closer and closer and closer. It's like my finish line marker. It's like where I start at and where I finish each time. It's like, all right, I can do it. I can do it. I know I've done it. I can make it. And it's that goal that I can like just see. I can like achieve that goal right there. And try and get faster and faster each time. And then, of course, just enjoying the scenery, especially if I'm by myself and have my music going. It's like that nice solace and that happy place that you can find and like be at one with yourself. And like I was saying, it's like that rare opportunity where you have a city with so many people, yet there's no one there, and you're by the water and you just see a little bit of light, and it's like you have the place to yourself. It's like you feel like you're the king of your own kingdom. That's what it really feels like. And then, of course, it comes to an end, and you're slowly reminded you're back in New York City, but the nice thing is that I can always go back there and have that little spot to myself, and only the few people that really know about it, that's it. That's night blading. The rollerblading community, at least here in New York City, I found pretty amazing. From the start, I thought it would be just myself and Cody rollerblading forever. Like, it would be two old men rollerblading up and down New York City and through Chelsea. But slowly, like a snowball, we meet one person that's into rollerblading, wants to join, then find another person, and make new friends. And before you know it, you almost have a whole little gang. It's like you have your own little, like, family. And they all have that one thing that we're into, and we love doing it. And if it's less of us, it's okay. If it's more of us, more the merrier. And the fact that we all have the same feeling and emotions about rollerblading and rollerblading in New York, the fact that it just brings us all together, and like we get to enjoy the city in a different way than other people don't get to enjoy the city, or maybe haven't realized it or forgot if they used to rollerblade. That's the other thing, is that I've ran into people that used to rollerblade and they've come to me like, I want to start rollerblading again. Like, you guys just inspire me to rollerblade. And that's the whole reason of like me really getting into it and sharing with everybody, is that I want to inspire people to get back on the rollerblades and rollerblade again. Like, it's a great exercise. It's a great thing for the soul, just to like be at one with yourself or be with a couple people, be active. And also the people that maybe have always thought about trying it, whether from a kid or as an adult, just to try something new. Because the worst thing is never to try it, and you always question it. If nothing else, why not do it with a bunch of people that are doing it regularly, and they'll help teach you and coach you along the way, and who knows, before you know it, you might be going just around the block, and then from around the block to 20 miles up and down Manhattan like it's nothing, and getting to really get an experience of the city in a different way that most people don't, whether they live here or not. And then also getting a good workout, and on top of that, just something that's great to enjoy, and it doesn't cost you an arm and a leg. It's just like cheap, fun, and a great way to be around people and meet people.